हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट दी अमीनो एसिड्स दैट फॉर्म सक्सिनाइल कोएंजाइम ए. ओके, नाउ दी निमोनिक हेयर इज दी शो मी दी आई वी. यू कैन से शो मी दी आई वी लाइन, बट लाइन इज नॉट यूज्ड हेयर. ओके, दी एस विल बी फॉर सक्सिनाइल को ए, दी एम फॉर दी मैथियोनिन, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वन दैट विल वी विल स्टडी इन डिटेल. And the TH is for threonine, I is for isoleucine, and V will be for valine. Now let's talk about the methionine first. That is the most important amino acid with respect to the formation of the succinyl coenzyme A. Okay, now let's talk about the metabolism of the methionine. First of all, the methionine that is present in our body, first of all, it will be converted methionine. Methionine first will be converted into a compound which is called the S-adenosyl methionine. As the name implies, the adenosine is required here for the formation of S-adenosyl methionine. Now, where does this adenosine come from? Of course, from the ATP, the adenosine triphosphate. The ATP will come and it will be released as 3 inorganic phosphate, and the adenosine will be added here as the adenosyl group. Now this adenosyl methionine has a methyl group attached to it, and this methyl group will be activated by the addition of the S-adenosyl methionine, and this S-adenosyl methionine will act as a donor of the methyl group. Now what will be, there are donors and so there must be acceptors. Now what compounds will accept this methyl from the S-adenosyl methionine? In the formation of the catecholamine, that is the epinephrine and the norepinephrine, the norepinephrine is converted into the epinephrine. This reaction occurs in the suprarenal medulla. The norepinephrine will come and the methyl group will be donated to the norepinephrine, converted into epinephrine. Now the remaining compound will be called S adenosyl homocysteine. The S adenosyl homocysteine is now formed. Now this S adenosyl homocysteine will break down into two compounds. First, the adenosine group will be removed and the remaining compound will be called homocysteine, and the adenosyl will be removed. Once we have formed the homocysteine, now the homocysteine has two fates depending upon the available of the methionine in the body. Now if the methionine is absent or deficient in the body, this homocysteine will be converted into methionine. The second fate of the homocysteine will be the serine. Now let's first talk about the methionine pathway. Now for the formation of the methionine, the homocysteine needs to have a methyl group, an extra methyl group. Now from where this methyl group will come from? Here there is the role of the two very important vitamins, that are the folic acid in the form of methyl tetrahydrofolate, and the second vitamin will be the vitamin B12 cobalamin in the form of methyl cobalamin. Now first, the methyl group that is present at the methyl cobalamin will be transferred to the homocysteine, forming methionine. And now the methyl tetrahydrofolate, the methyl group present at the tetrahydrofolate will be donated to the cobalamin, so that the cobalamin is then regenerated and the tetrahydrofolate is left. This is one of the two reactions that requires the vitamin B12. The next reaction we will talk about later. Now let's talk about the formation of cysteine from homocysteine. That how this homocysteine leads to the formation of cysteine. Basically, the formation of cysteine requires the addition of serine, which is another amino acid. Now, when the serine is added to the homocysteine, and in the presence of an enzyme that is called the cystathione synthase, the resulting compound, of course, will be cystathione. Now this cystathione will break down into two compounds. first it will form cysteine, and the second compound will be alpha keto butyrate, not alpha keto glutarate. It is the alpha keto butyrate that is formed as a result of the lysis of cystathione. The enzyme here will present is the cystathione lyase, and the coenzyme required is the vitamin B6. Now, what will be the fate of alpha ketoglutarate? You must have noticed that up till now we have not formed the succinyl CoA. In the first few minutes of this video, we talked about the formation of the succinyl CoA from methionine. But here, it will lead to the formation of the succinyl CoA. Now, the alpha ketobutyrate will undergo oxidative decarboxylation, I think, and the propionyl coenzyme A compound is formed. Now this propionyl coenzyme A will be converted into the our friend succinyl coenzyme A. Let's review. The homocysteine will combine with serine to form cystathione. The cystathione will decompose, or you can say it will divide into two compounds, cysteine and the alpha ketobutyrate, and then the alpha ketobutyrate is converted to propionyl CoA, and then finally into the succinyl CoA coenzyme A. Now the cysteine is a non-essential amino acid because the methionine that is present is the essential amino acid, and it can be formed. Cysteine is only essential because when the methionine is absent, because when the methionine is not here, the homocysteine is not being formed, and in this way the cysteine is not being formed. Same is the case with the amino acid the cysteine is only the amino acid that we call the conditionally essential amino acid. Now let's talk about some clinically important landmarks related with the formation of the homocysteine. The accumulation of the homocysteine in the body fluid is associated with cardiovascular diseases. The exact mechanism is not known, but when the patient has deficiency of any enzyme which include B6, vitamin B12 or folic acid, it will lead to the homocystinuria or homocystinemia, which means that homocysteine concentration will be increased in the body fluid. As you know that the B6, B12 and folic acid vitamins are involved in the metabolism of the homocysteine into methionine or into cysteine. When these vitamins are deficient, the homocysteine is not metabolized and it starts accumulating, and it will lead to the formation of incidence of the cardiovascular diseases. Now let's talk about other amino acids that led to the formation of succinyl coenzyme A. The first amino acid that we need to talk about is the threonine. Basically, this threonine is first converted into alpha keto butyrate, and alpha ketobutyrate, just like the previous reaction, it will be converted first into propionyl coenzyme A, and then this propionyl coenzyme A will be converted into succinyl coenzyme A. The next amino acids, the next two amino acids that led to the formation of the succinyl coenzyme A are valine and isoleucine. These both are the branch chain amino acid. We will talk about the metabolism of branch chain amino acid later in some video. Okay, now the valine and isoleucine, both of them will form the propionyl coenzyme A, and this propionyl coenzyme A will be converted into methyl malonyl coenzyme A. This methyl malonyl coenzyme A is then converted into succinyl coenzyme A. The conversion of the methyl malonyl coenzyme A into succinyl coenzyme A requires the vitamin B12, but here the adenosylcobalamin form of the vitamin B12 is required. Now, if the vitamin B12 is deficient in the patient, the branch chain amino acid metabolism is impaired, and these branch chain amino acid starts accumulating in the membranes, particularly in the neurons, and it leads to the manifestation of peripheral neuropathy, tingling of the hands and fingers, the numbness of the foot and hands, and this is a clinical application of this metabolism of isoleucine and valine.